today's session, I am Vandana Reddy, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Dundigal, Hyderabad. So in this session, I am going to explain you about determination of optimal dosage of coagulant. And what is the coagulant and what is the purpose of the coagulant? We do know now. So in case of a water treatment plant, so initially, after screening, the water will be sent to the plain sedimentation tank where the water will be consisting of suspended particles. And in the plain sedimentation tank, so few particles we can remove them. But what are the particles which are very fine and colloidal particles, we can't remove easily because of the plain sedimentation. So for that particular water, so we are going to add coagulants. So the coagulants, what the intensity of providing the coagulants is nothing but, so whenever we are going to add the coagulants to the particular water, so whatever the suspended particles are there, so it is going to combine each other. So and it is going to form in the form of the flocks, and we can remove those particular particles easily. So that is why we need to determine the how much amount of coagulant we require in order to combine those particles, suspended particles, and remove them. The apparatus required for this experiment are flocculator, otherwise we may call it as a jar test apparatus, and a beaker, and a measuring jar, and a weighing machine, and nebulometer turbidity apparatus. And if you come to the procedure, so in this particular flocculator, it is consisting of 6 number of jars, and each jar is having a capacity of 1 liter. And if you observe here, so here you can observe 3 operating things. So one thing is on and off. So if you on this, the particular jar test apparatus is going to switch on, and this is used to regulate the speed, middle knob, and the last one is switch is to use the light. Okay, so initially what we have to do in the sense, we have to fill each jar which is having 1 liter capacity. So after the bath, we need to fill the water in each and every jar. After that, we need to add different amounts of coagulant solution. So in general, we'll be taking RM solution as a coagulant because it is very economical, leaner, it works effectively. So if at all this particular jar we have added 1 ml, so then we need to add 2 ml for the next jar. So 3 ml, 4 ml, 5 ml, 6 ml. So likewise with varying in the alum solution, we need to add the in each and every beaker. So after that, what we have to do, we have to switch on the apparatus. Initially, we have to place this and operate the speed, and we have to set it to 100 rpm. After that, this particular pedal inside this one, it starts going moving, and we have to allow it for 1 minute or 2 minutes. After that, again, we need to reduce the speed to 30 to 40 rpm, and we have to allow it for 30 minutes or 40 minutes in between. So after that, we have to allow the settlement for 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes, what happens in the sense, because of the movement in this pedal, the water is going to move, and whatever suspended particles are there, it is going to combine with each other because of the addition of the RM solution in the beaker. So after that, what we have to do in the sense, by using the nebulometer turbidity apparatus, we are going to determine the turbidity for each and every water sample. And at the end, we are going to plot a graph. So in x-axis, we need to mention this alum solution. So starting with 1 ml, and it is going to up to 20 ml or 30 ml. And in the y-axis, we are going to take the stability value. So, from the graph, we are going to obtain the optimum dosage of coagulant. So, for which amount of coagulant, the stability of the water is less. So, that particular value will be calling it as a optimum value of the coagulant. So, that will be used for that particular water sample in order to remove the turbidity. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.